What we have here is a Civil Defense Survival Supplies Barrel. This barrel was manufactured in 1963, and it was issued by the United States government to be placed in fallout shelters all across America in case of a nuclear attack. These would have been found in public fallout shelters or even private fallout shelters in the basement of someone's home. When most people think of the 1960s in the United States, they think about hippies, Woodstock, peace and love, the Vietnam War, of course. But at the forefront of everyone's mind back then was the Cold War, the Russians, nuclear attack, building fallout shelters in their basements. Well, I'm glad you clicked on the video today. That means you're into this kind of stuff. I am too. I love Cold War history. It's just a bygone era that's quickly being forgotten. Relics like this are being scrapped, recycled. All right, let's go ahead and take a closer look at this Civil Defense Survival Supplies Barrel. The one I have here today is a little rusty. It is empty. There's nothing in it. Survival supplies furnished by Office of Civil Defense, Department of Defense. 17 and a half gallons. Well, that's kind of a crazy size for a barrel, 17 and a half gallons. Why would they do that? Well, the U.S. government recommended that in your fallout shelter, you should have a quart of water per day, per person, and this barrel was designed to supply water for up to 5 people. So 5 people, a quart of water, times 14 days, comes out to 17 and a half gallons of water. So what you would do with this, you would store it in your fallout shelter. There were some supplies inside of it. You take the supplies out, and you would put like a trash bag liner in it and fill it with water. One of the supplies furnished was a pump, like a little hand pump. And they also had some iodine tablets. It talks about put the water in there, drop in the iodine tablets, wait 5 minutes. And that would be enough water for 5 people for 14 days. Now, once you were done with the water, you would reuse this as a commode. One of the supplies that was in here was a plastic lid, kind of a donut-shaped lid that went on the top here. I'll put a picture in the video. And then you put the liner in there and you did your business in the barrel. You would fill this up to this line here with poop and pee. Fill it up to that high with water, and then once you were done using it as a water tank, this became your toilet. Two birds, one stone. This is a storage container, not intended to be used for shipping water. Manufactured by the Rheem Company, Kedzie Avenue, Chicago, Illinois. So what supplies would have come in this barrel? Well, there would have been toilet paper. There would have been feminine hygiene products. There would have been a pump. There would have been some iodine tablets for water purification. And there would have been a commode chemical. You put the chemical in there to kind of keep the poo smell down when you were using it as a toilet. There might have also been some like tins of government crackers. Yeah, if you're into this sort of thing, these are still readily available on eBay. You can look on Craigslist, the Facebook Exchange, what have you. They're still out there. People are still finding these in Grandpa's basement when they go to clean it out. Maybe Grandpa had a fallout shelter back in the day. They're finding these and they don't know what to do with them. They're too cool to just scrap. Have you ever seen one of these before? Is this bringing back some memories? Leave a comment below. I'd love to hear your story. If you enjoyed this video, go ahead and hit that like button. Give it a thumbs up. While you're at it, might as well hit subscribe too. I'd appreciate that. All right, I want to say thanks for watching, and I hope you have a great day.